Hello everyone! Today I'm going to show you how you can create interactive math activities like this using Google Slides. Let's get started. First we're going to start in Google Drawing and create our background image. And we need to make sure that our canvas size and drawing is the same as Google Slides. So we're going to go to File, Page Setup. We're going to change the page setup to widescreen 16:9. Now it's the same size. Now I'm going to insert my 10 frame by using a table. Insert table. I'm going to do a 5x2. I'm going to adjust it. Go ahead and make my boxes bigger by just hitting enter. And now I'm going to select the entire table so that I can make the lines a different color and thicker. Oops, too thick. Let's change that back. All right. Now at the bottom, I'm going to create a visual support for math equations. So I'm going to go to Shapes. And first I'm going to draw a circle. Now if you hold down the shift key while you do this, you'll get a perfect circle instead of an oval. I'm going to make this red. Now I'm going to draw a square. Again, shapes and square. Again, if you hold down the shift key, you'll draw a square instead of a rectangle. I don't want this one red. I'm going to change the color to yellow. And now I need a plus and equals. So for that, I'm going to use a text box. I'm going to go ahead and type my plus. It's way too small. So I'm going to come in and change the font size till I find something that I like. Go ahead and center that. And I'm going to draw a line to represent where students are going to write the sum. Change the width. I'm going to select my equal sign. I'm going to hold down the option or control key to copy. Change that to an equal. Do some final adjustments. And I'm pretty happy with this. So let's go ahead and name it. And now I'm going to download this as an image file. To download, File, Menu, Download, and you want to choose PNG. There it is. Now I'm going to switch to Google Slides. I'm going to go ahead and change the layout so I can get rid of those boxes, make it blank. And now I'm going to insert my image. You can do that by a right click on the background of your slide. Choose change background, then choose image, and I can just drag that file I just downloaded. Now here you have a choice. If I click done, that background will only be on that slide. If I choose add to theme, then it will be on any slide that I add to this file. So I'm going to go ahead and choose add to theme, and then click done. So now as you can see, this is the background. So there's no moving any of these pieces. So now I'm ready to create my math manipulatives. So I'm going to do the same thing and draw a circle using my shape tool. Remember that shift key trick so you get a perfect circle. Use the paint bucket to change the color. And then do the same thing for the square. Now I could have also done this in separate Google Drawing file and then downloaded it as an image file and dragged it in here. I definitely recommend doing it in Google Drawing, especially if you are doing something like Place Value Disk that has a drawing plus some text.
I wanted to jump in and talk about accessibility for a minute. Instead of trying to replicate exactly those red and yellow round manipulatives you may have in your classroom, I made a deliberate design choice in the name of accessibility. Colorblindness is prevalent among boys and oftentimes can go undiagnosed, particularly in the earlier grades. And as teachers, we love our color coding. It's a great strategy. And sometimes, unknowingly, we fall in the trap of, get out your blue notebook. How many blue bears do you have? How many red bears do you have? And all of those choices, whether visually or what we're saying orally, are not accessible for our students who may be experiencing color blindness. So the tip is, you never want to communicate meaning by color alone. By deliberately making a red circle and a yellow square, and in my questioning, I can ask students, how many red circles do you have? How many yellow squares? So instead of just using how many red and yellow pieces do you have this additional layer of meaning that is going to create a more inclusive activity that more students in your classroom will be able to access. Now back to finishing up this design.
Now that you have your counter shapes, I'm going to show you how you can stack them. So when students drag them onto the 10 frame, they have one underneath. Also give you something to consider when thinking about connectivity. So you're going to select the shape, and here I recommend doing a command or control D to duplicate and do that multiple times. Then go ahead and select all of the shapes, go to the range menu, align, line left. We're going to do that again, arrange, align, top. Now you have a stack of those counters. You're going to repeat this process for the square. Command or control D to duplicate multiple times. Then select all the shapes. Go to arrange, align, left, and then align at the top. Now you have a stack of manipulatives. Something to consider with this stack of shapes is, depending on connectivity, they can take a long time to load within the file. And so one thing that you can do instead of creating the stack is to teach students how to duplicate the shape, either using that command or control D, or selecting the shape, holding down the control button if they're on a Chromebook or a PC. On a Mac, it's the option button, and they can just select the shape, drag it, and then release. And that automatically duplicates the shape. Now I'm ready to add text boxes to our number sentence frame down below. So I'm going to use the text box, go ahead and draw it over the shape. I want to change the font size. I'm going to center the text. And then I'm going to use that copy trick of holding down the option or control key, selecting the shape, and then going ahead and dragging it. That's going to keep my formatting consistent across the number sentence. Now I'm ready to give my file a title, and then I'm going to make sure and double check that everything is how I want it in slide one, because then you can click on slide one, do a right click on slide one in the sidebar, and then duplicate it. And it's going to have all those components, and you're ready to use this in your LMS or during live instruction so that every student has a slide where they can model their thinking in terms of addition. If you learned something new today, give this video a like and consider subscribing for future videos. Until next time, bye everyone.